Okay, as another review, so let's get straight to it. Also, by the way, I'll just let you know, I did actually do a review of this last year. I actually purchased this locomotive last year from S&J Models, and I purchased it with Sue and John, which the owners of S&J Models, and Nick, that also works there. There's another shout out to you, Nick, LMS 16440. So if you haven't checked his channel out, that's LMS 16440. I'll probably put a link down in the description below, so please check that out. And yeah, I really do appreciate Nick's help, and also a big thank you to Sue and John, the owners of S&J Models in Cheshire. So okay, let's get to this review. So obviously we can see it's a Hornby product, and you can see by the nameplate there, it's the Duchess of Hamilton. My camera's playing up a little bit today, I don't know why. Obviously this, I was going to make a comment now. Okay, I know that these locomotives are, you usually get the streamlined and de-streamlined versions, and they are nicknamed Duchess of this and Duchess of that, but they are a Coronation Class locomotive. Okay, this is a Coronation Class steam locomotive. How can I say, well, to be honest with you, I wasn't really that into them when I was younger. I personally thought they were quite, I don't know how to put it, an unattractive steam locomotive. A lot of people will probably have a go at me for saying that, but now I must admit I do like them very much. They are really, really stunning steam locomotives. It's kind of like a an Art Deco formation. That's what I call it. It's an art. It's an Art Deco steam locomotive, really. It shouts out 1930s to you, doesn't it? Really. Anyway, me chit chatting. Let's have a look at the model inside. Let's see what we got here. It's a number R, reference number R3101, and it's LMS 462 wheel arrangement, Coronation Class locomotive, and the running number is 6229, and the name Duchess of Hamilton, and it does say 99 quid there, but I don't think I paid 99 for it. I think I got a good price from S&J Models, which I'm highly grateful for. I'm going to take the sleeve off. Actually, before we look at the model, I did forget to mention that this is a NRM, National Railway Museum Special Edition model. So the National Railway Museum have commissioned Hornby to produce this model. So let's turn on the back, because it's Hornby's brief history, which is nice. And obviously you can see the prototype locomotive there, a picture of her outside the National Railway Museum in York, and some nice information on her. So if you wish to pause the video and you can read the information. Don't know if I got it all in shot there. Obviously Princess Coronation Class 6229, a Duchess of Hamilton designed by William Stanier, and was built in 1938 by crew by the London, Midland and Scottish Railway, so the LMS. And yeah, this is reserved at the most powerful steam locomotive ever to run in Britain. The Princess Coronation Class engines were a stunning representation. Oh, there you go, a stunning representation of Art Deco appearance. Okay, let's have a look at the model itself. Okay, let's open the box and see what we get inside. Let's quite basic, really. Basic packaging. Hornby's like older style packaging, this one. And we take off the white sleeve, playing havoc with the autofocus again. And we have a look at the instructions model down. So this is the first only one I've got so far of Duchess class. Actually, tell a lie, I do have a D streamline, but again, that's another review. Anyway, this one is a K462 steam locomotive and tender DCC ready. Yes, it's just DCC ready, this model, and stroke DCC fitted sound. So this one is a DCC ready model. But I will like to inform you of something. Okay, open up the instructions. It's the Hornby's usual style instructions on where to lubricate, how to dismantle the body, so how body removal. You have to be careful with the speedo there. Assembly, so basically a plug and pin arrangement, and also you can see how to take the tender apart and where the DCC decoder or provision for sound is located. But I do actually need to point out something. This is a model of about, I think this model came out in 2012, I'm sure it is. This version is 2012, this packaging. If you look in the 2012 catalogue. Okay, yep, I've got to say I'm back as well. I keep on saying I'm back all the time. Okay, you join with me the review of the Duchess of Hamilton. I've got the Hornby 2012 catalogue, and if we just turn to the page I've marked it at, there you go. National Railway Museum, Duchess of Hamilton, NRM special. There you go. R3101. Okay, so that is 2012 model. Here are R3101. Okay, but this model isn't the 2012 version. This one is the 2008-2009 version, and I'll show you for why. Okay, let's start with the tender first. I can show you straight away. Okay, excuse the tissue paper as it's wrapped up in. It's a nice tender. We will have a look at the tender first, actually, as I've got it out. But just to tell you, it's got that hook. So that's how I know that it isn't the 2012 version, but the 2008-2009 version. Because on the 2012 version, you have a plug and pin arrangement, which is shown in the instructions. But never to worry, it's not too bad. It doesn't really bother me. I'm glad I've got one anyway. Anyway, let's take a look at the tender. First of all, there's molded non-removable coal load in this tender, which I'm afraid you can't remove. You could do one or two things here. You can either go over it with a fine amount of realistic coal and glue it to the original, or you can cut this out. I mean, I know some modellers that have done it, and it is possible. Cut out the realistic coal and make up your own style coal bunker and put your own coal in that way. I know some people have done that, and it is possible. But there is a lot of work involved. Or the other option is you just leave it as is, or just paint it and just weather it. So there are other options. Striking, really, isn't it? A nice livery application and a nice application of the gold lining goes through. It's like a speed stripe, really, and the LMS logo on the side of the tender. A little bit of rivet detail on the bottom there. I really can't get my words out today. As I was saying, it's a nice way of doing things closer to the prototype. It's moulded, but it's there anyway. Also, we've got sprung buffers. There we go. And we've got some vacuum piping, which has already been added. I don't know whether the previous owner added that or the factory added it, I'm not too sure. We've got a nice ladder there, and obviously tender capacity and tender type. And that's where you fill the water up. Let's have a look at the side. We've got some handrails at the sides here, and some moulded details on the inside here. It's quite nice anyway. So there will be pickups in the tender for this model. Yep, we can see the brass pickups. And also we have a slimline tension lock in a NEM pocket, which you can see just there, which is nice. Oh, that's decided to come out. I need to add the brake rig into this. So that's the tender. Okay, let's move on to the locomotive herself. Let's take let's take some of the packaging out, off shot, and remove. It's the old style, put your finger through the whole jobby, which I'm not too keen on, by the way. I'm not too keen on even this model being in this style of packaging. Actually, there are some accessories. We'll have a look at them first. It's really awkward bending down off over these. Let's have a look what we get here. Looks like we get an extra bogie. To my knowledge, this is to do with the radius of curve you want to go around. I think if you want to go on smaller radius, I think it's this bogie. I'm not too sure on that. I don't know which is which, but one of them's a smaller radius and one of them's for larger radius anyway. So that's that. And also we get some accessories here. Ah, here we go. We've got a flanged wheel here. So obviously on the rear of this model we've got flangeless. So if you want to fit the flanged wheel, you can do. But again, you can't go around tight curves. And we've also got some vacuum brake piping and some brake rigging, which is nice. Yeah, that's good. Okay, let's take the tissue paper. This tissue paper gets ripped up hot. It's really horrible. That was terrible, that tissue paper. Oh, I should take that out. And just go around the other way. I prefer holding them like this. Okay. As you already know, there is a running video attached to this. I've already done a running video. I'm just re-reviewing this one. So, sprung buffers. Excellent. And obviously we've got a little ladder added there, and there's some vacuum tube in there. I haven't added that, it was already there. Some footsteps, lamp irons, I think they're handles, metal handrails, handles. Some there and some there. Really nice front end to this loco. And then a nice gold lining going around into the middle. They've even got lamp irons on the front there, on the buffer beam, which is nice. The model's covered up with the casing. The name, Duchess of Hamilton. Obviously you've got a nice metal rail going all the way along the boiler, and that name plate looks raised, but it's printed on there. So I could again get another brass etched nameplate from Fox Transfers, and add that to it. And also we got an, I think it's a builder's plate LMS. Can't read that out quite clearly at the moment. Anyway, nice valve gear. It's really nice. And this is a loco driven. It's not tender drive, which I like. I do like the motor being where it should be in the actual locomotive itself. Nice chimney there. Pretty basic, but it's nice. And obviously safety valves and the whistle just there. Looks like it's buried. The cab roof doors don't open, I'm afraid, on this model. Let's have a look inside the cab. Just about make that out. Yep, there you go. It's details there, molded details, but it's very basic. Obviously you got the handrails at the side and the clasp for the this style of transmitting power to the tender for extra pickups. I mean, yeah, it is a nice loco. The only thing is this bogie wants to swing around like anything. Yeah, let's turn it upside down and you can see the flangeless. Yeah, see, if you want to replace it, you just unscrew that screw and swap them over. So that's all fixed, the rear truck, which is nice. And there is some nice details down below here, nice pipe work there. Hornby have done a good job, but I would say it's probably due for a retooling. I mean, we could improve this model quite a bit, but as it is, I still quite like it. Okay, so let's have a closer look, and then we'll go to the running. Oh, and also, by the way, there is a lot of weight, so that would an aid for traction. Keep on forgetting, these models are quite heavy. A lot heavier than what they used to be anyway, which is good. So it means that she can pull quite heavy trains. There we go. Okay, you join me in the white box. Obviously I told you about the sprung buffers, and as you can see, there's a lamp hook just there. If I could just zoom in a bit more, actually. There we go. We've got the lamp hook there, and we've got some details down below. We've got vacuum hosing already applied, which I didn't add, and also this I don't know if it's a ladder or a guard protector. And obviously there's a hook there and some footsteps, another lamp hook and some more footsteps, and some handles, metal handles, which is nicely applied. The livery is quite good. Obviously we go up to the air smooth casing at the top. Obviously this opens up, and obviously you can get access to the actual smoke box underneath the front of this air smooth casing, so that can be removed. And then they obviously, when the cleaners come along, they would shovel out the soot collection that's built up in the smoke box, and you just shovel that out, which is a very dirty job, by the way, and I have done it a couple of times, quite a few times, and it is a messy job. But it's all the fun of working on a steam locomotive. Back to this review. Obviously some more metal handles there, and some as a lamp hook there. I think that's the handle to open it up. I think so, I'm not too sure. Okay, obviously we've got the chimney, so that's quite nice and depicted. And obviously we've got the metal handrails that go along the length of the boiler as well. If I move the camera slightly, and then we've got the name, Duchess of Hamilton, and goes along the length. Let's have a look at the valve gear. Okay, you can't see much of it, but Hornby have done an excellent job here. I mean, I know it's all covered up with the air smooth casing, but still, I mean, this is nice. I keep saying air smooth casing, it's streamlined. Air smooth casings on the bullets, but yeah, streamlined. So yeah, it's all covered up, but still you can see parts of the mechanism, which is quite nice. And it is quite fine details there. I wonder if I can get on that builder's plate. Okay, you've obviously got the builder's plate, but I can't really make it out that well. I think it says LMS crew and the date, 1938, I think it does. And obviously we've got the number 6229, which is a running number during LMS days. And obviously I did tell you about the name, Duchess of Hamilton. And I might get a etched nameplate for her there. Let's have a look in the cab. Okay, let's have a look in the cab. Obviously we can see there is molded detail there, but it's not that, it's just very basic. If you wanted to paint it and make it look really realistic, but I really would like Hornby to redo this model and redo the details inside. I know they can do it, and if they do, it'll be a good addition. But the model as it is overall quite fine, to be honest. And go to the other side. Obviously there's this pipework detail which Hornby have added, which I quite like. It's there and it's supposed to be there, and I'm glad that they've done the work and put it there. Obviously you can see on there, I think there's 7P, so 7 passenger. And obviously we've got the gold lining that goes all the way along the length of the loco. Remove the camera a bit more. And it's a stunning addition. I'm really impressed with it. Let's have a look at the tender as well. Okay, we're on the tender, and obviously there is some, there's a handle there and a handle there which Hornby have added, which is nice. But there is majority of its molded details, but still, it's still quite a nice representation. LMS livery. Yeah, I like it. Let's turn to the rear. Obviously you got the builder's plate and water capacity. So it'll be LMS crew 1938. I'm not too sure how well this camera's picking it out, but it's nice. Okay, there we have it. It's quite a nice model and quite a nice addition to my fleet. I would also like to mention, also, if you ever look at my reviews, please also look at the description down below, which I give a written description as well, which tells you a bit more in depth towards the performance and other things related to this model. But anyway, it's a nice addition, and I'll get back to some more reviews. Thank you for watching.